They told me everybody's 15 minutes in a different time zone. And since I have it at the moment, you the one I wanna shine my light on. Get your life, little mama, won't you get your life on? Ain't nothing cooler than the wrong moves when you do them to the right song, the right song.
Hello everybody, today we are going to do the battle of the Wella Toners. I have several Wella Toners over here that I want to use on some dyed bleach hair. I dyed some regular black hair into this little orangey color. I used 40 volumes, so it got pretty orangey, and now I want to tone it. I look on YouTube and I watch all these videos about how people use all these different Wella Toners to tone their hair. So today I'll be using several Wella Toners and using little pieces. As you can tell with my setup over here, I am ready. Your girl is ready. I also am going to put these toners side by side with this 613 hair. A lot of people try and dye their 613 hair these days into ashy colors or a more toned down color. Some people also dye blonde hair in the salon, and they dye hair into blonde and they want to tone it with some Wella Toners. So today, hopefully we can all learn together. The Wella Toners that I'm going to be using are T10, T14, T15, T18, T27, and T35. Towards the end, I will mix the T27 and T35 together and see how it's gonna look on both these hairs. I see people do a lot of mixture of the two, so I figured why not try that also on my bundle hair and see how it looks like. I am going to be using 20 volume according to the 20 volume developer. It's Wella dedicated developer in Color Charm. According to the instructions on the box, it says to use one part of Wella toner to two parts of developer, so that's exactly what I'm going to be using. I have a measuring cup over here to mix up and measure. I have my timer ready. I have my iPhone timer also set just in case my timer doesn't do what it needs to do. So I'm ready to go. You all watch me and let's see how this goes. But I hope, hopefully we can all learn something as I have a nice variation of toners here so that we can use and see how it looks like. So let's all stay tuned. As you can all see my setup over here, I have about 5 ounces of toner in every bowl that I have right now. This is the T10, T14, and T18. So I have measured some amount of developer. So I'm gonna pour about 10 ounces in each of it. So that's 2 times the amount. This I'm putting 10 in here too. I have another 10 that I'm putting here too. So I'm going ahead and I'm mixing up all the different mixtures. This is the T10 with the developer in there. It becomes a very jelly consistency. See that? That's the T14. I'm mixing that one up too. And this is the T15. Now that I've mixed up everything, I'm just going ahead and apply to all the different hairs that I have. I'm trying to make sure that everything is super saturated so that it will develop the tone. So I'm putting it on here. And I'm putting it also on the 613 hair. I don't want anything to mix up. There you go. Same with this one. I'm putting the T14 on the I've applied it very quickly and I've set my timer up to 30 minutes. Let's start it. I have the TAT mixture here. I have the T27 mixture here. I mix it like just like how I mix the other ones. One part of toner to two parts of developer. I have the T35 here mixture. I pretty much labeled all my clear path plastic containers what they are. And then I have the T35 and T27 mixture that I think is kind of popular. I see a lot of people mix those two together. So I kind of wanted to see what the outcome of that is going to be. So I have everything together. I'm going to time this one with my iPhone. So let me set it properly for 30 minutes. And let me just apply it quickly so it can all develop at the same time, I guess. So I'm applying the T18 on the orangey hair, the T18 on the blonde hair. T27. The orangey hair. T35 on the orangey hair. T35 on the blonde hair. Then I have the T35 and T27 mixture. Gonna go ahead and start my timer on my iPhone for these two for 30 minutes. Let's start. As you can tell, they are all developing. The first set is almost like done. I have like 13 minutes left. And the next set has quite a bit of time, about 23 minutes. I did them spaced out so that they can all develop at the required time and not left over. So as you can tell that the T14 is like really, really, really ashy. So it's coming along. As you can tell, they're all changing color. They are not like the orangey. Some of them have changed color. And I will come back as soon as all of these are developed. I'll wash them all and then I can come back and show you. Hi guys, I am back and every single one of the swatches that I made have been developed. As you can tell, they are all done. I dried them all up and they have all chain tone at some level. The T10, the T14, T15, T18, T27, T35, and T35 and T27 mixture. I'm going to go through them one by one so you can see, I guess, the change in tones and my thoughts on it. And you can also make your decisions as to which ones you will use next time you're ready to dye your bundles. Hi, so I'm back and everything is developed. If you can see here on my little table, I've lined everything up and it seems like everything is dried up, developed, so we can actually talk through it. So I have the, it's daylight today because I decided to do it during the day. And if you can see the orangey hair, this is the T10. And you can tell that it kind of darkened it up a little bit. It's not as orangey anymore. And this is the T10 in the 613 hair. So if I put it side by side, you can tell that 613 hair also kind of darkened up a little bit. It kind of, you know, it toned the yellow out and also darkened the orange. So yeah, this is how your T10 will look like, just in case you ever decided that you were going to tone your orange hair or your bundle that you have dyed with bleach. This is how it's going to look like, and this is your 613 hair. I let it sit for 30 minutes for all the different swatches that I had. Now for, this is the T14. The T14 hair, it got ashy, and that's what it's supposed to do. The T14 hair is pale ash blonde. So it got ashy. Here you go. I believe that it probably has a little bit of like a blue tone in it. So it has like a slight tint of blue in it in the 613 hair. And this is the orange hair. I don't think it got as ashy as I thought it was supposed to be, since it's supposed to be a pale ash blonde. But again, it didn't really make this orangey hair ashy. It however made the 613 hair very ashy. It's almost like ash when you look at it, like the more like a silver tone, like a grayish tone. So yeah, so if you kind of wanted to make your 613 hair grayish, this might be a good toner to use, this T14 pale ash blonde. The orangey hair, it didn't turn really ashy, so here you go. It did take some orange tones out of it, but I do like the T14 on the 613 hair more. So this is the T15, which is pale beige blonde. The beige toners have some type of blue in it. The 613 hair got, like, it looks almost sandy to me. Very sandy. Very, very sandy to me. Sandy hair. If you look at the orange hair, it kind of got a little bit, a slightly dark brown. I kind of like the tone, the T15 tone. It has some type of beige in there, blue tone in it. So it did cancel out some orange, as you can tell. So it's not as orangey. It seemed a little bit muted out. And this is how the 613 hair and the orangey type hair look side by side together. And this is pretty much sandy blonde when you look at it side to side. Now the T18 hair, it is the most popular toner on YouTube. It has it got ashy for the 613, and when you look at the orangey hair, I didn't really see much happen. I guess it also depends on the, you know, the levels of orange that you have in your bundle hair. This, when it was developing, looked like it had, it was almost like a purple tone, and it's pale. It's the lightest ash blonde, this ash brown T18 hair. So if you put it on super blonde hair, almost platinum hair, you begin some type of bluish purpley type color. It takes out all the yellow tones in it. It is definitely lighter than the T14. Which is more like a pale ash, and this is the lightest ash. The orangey hair, this is how it came out, close and side to side with the 613 hair. So it toned it out a little bit, but it also didn't get ashy. And I believe that because it's the lightest ash, it didn't really do much to it, because it took out the yellow tones in the 613 hair, and this, I don't see any type of ash in it. So there you go for the T18 hair. Okay, so this is the T27. Now the T27, I liked how it came out for the orangey hair. It got darker too, just like the T15 did. I'm believing that since it's a medium beige blonde, since it has some type of blue tones in it, it does cancel out the orange as is. So this right here is not orangey anymore. It's more like a nice neutral, like dark brown color or light brown color, as you can tell. And then this hair, which is a 613, you know, it dulled it down a little bit. It just dulled it down a little. So T27 has a blue tone in it, a medium beige blonde. And this is how the T27 came out. So, you know, if I was dyeing my, if I was dyeing my bundle and it got orangey, I like how the T27 came out. I really do like it. It pretty much dulled it down and it doesn't look orangey to me. T35 is also very popular on YouTube. Very similar to the T27. It has the more of a beigey color in it. It is the beige blonde. So it gave us like pretty much similar results like the T27 did. You can tell that the 613 hair dulled it down a little bit. The 613 hair, and this is the orangey hair. And as you can tell, the orange is gone. It has beige, and it probably has more beige in it than the T27. So you can tell that it looks toned down. The orangey hair is toned down. It's not as orange. And the 613 hair has been toned down because it has that blue beige tone in it. So this was the bonus one where I mixed the T27 and T35. I like the mixture. It came out very similar to the T35. So if you mix the two, both of these colors, the T27 and T35, have beige in it. And so definitely it will take out your orangey tone in your orange hair. And of course, the 613 hair will be a little bit darkened up, right? Because it has blue tones and it's going to darken it up a little bit. So from all these swatches that I tested today, what I can tell you is that if you definitely want to take your orangey out of your hair that you're dyeing, or even your bundle hair, and you dye it, it's black and you lift it up with higher level developer, 40 volume, 30 volume, and then it becomes very orange like the beginning swatch that I showed you, you should be leaning towards T27 and leaning towards T35 to take out the orangey tones in it, because it has beige in it and a bluish tone in it, and blue, according to the color theory, removes out all your orange. Now, if you were more so dying, if you would kind of like wanted to tone your 613 hair in a more ashy range, then you'd be looking towards T14, which is like a pale ash blonde, and be looking at T18, which is more like it's a light ash. So it's definitely lighter than the T14, but it gives you a nice little tone of ash. So what I would say is that the lighter your hair is, the more ashy it will look, and it will become ashy. So you'll be using the more ashy tones. And if you kind of want more of a neutral color, toned down color, where it's not looking too bright and orangey, you'll be looking at the T27 and the T35. You know, even the mixtures are nice. And if you're looking for a more sandy type blonde color, you'll be looking at the T15, which we, you know, as like I showed you, it looks very sandy. It's not ash. It's not necessarily, you know, like a real blonde. It looks like really toned down sandy blonde. So the T10 also look really nice. So you can just go ahead and just look at all these swatches that I showed you and then make a good decision or informed decision about what you use to tone your bundles or even hair when you lighten it up. So thank you for watching today. This was very exciting and very educative for both me and I'm sure for you too. And stay tuned for my next video. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe, and let me know if you like this type of video or videos like this, which is more educative, and actually you can see what you want to see when you dye your hair bundles. Let me know. Thank you so much.
What is this magic? My name is I need that magic.
Everywhere you go is the main attraction. Your yarn shows a house to be a man.